In the previous video, we discussed contribution margins as they related to the sale of one product, baseball caps. But in reality, most companies sell much more than just one product. For multi-product companies, we need to find what is called the sales mix, which is the ratio of sales volume for the various products that the company sells. Let's say that our company has expanded and now sells top hats and sombreros in addition to their baseball caps. An example of a sales mix might be 10-5-3, meaning that for every 10 baseball caps sold, 5 top hats are sold and 3 sombreros are sold. A composite unit takes into account the sales mix and can be thought of as the average bag of goods sold. It is the composite unit of 10 baseball caps, 5 top hats, and 3 sombreros to which we will apply our cost volume profit analysis on, instead of to individual products as we have done previously. Now, don't get confused here. This doesn't mean that the company has a bundled deal to sell 10 baseball caps, 5 top hats, and 3 sombreros at some deal-breaking price all bundled together, although if they wanted to, they could do that. The composite unit here just means that when we consult our sales records at the end of the month, they tend to end up in these proportions. Now let's assume that we have the following selling price and variable cost per unit for the three products. We can find the selling price per composite unit first by focusing on one product at a time. For baseball caps, there are 10 caps in each composite unit, and the selling price is $10 each. So 10 units times $10 is equal to $100. For top hats, there are 5 hats in a composite unit, and the selling price is $15 each. So 5 units times $15 is equal to $75. Hopefully you can confirm that by using the same process, the sombreros contribute $60 to the composite unit selling price. To find the selling price per composite unit, just add the three numbers together. 100 plus 75 plus 60 equals $235 selling price per composite unit. We can use the same process to find the variable cost per composite unit. For baseball caps, again we take the 10 caps in a composite unit, but instead of looking to the $10 selling price, we look at the $6 variable costs. 10 units times $6 in variable costs gives us $60 in variable costs contributed by the baseball caps. Using the same process for top hats and sombreros, we get $40 and $27. The total variable cost per composite unit is 60 plus 40 plus 27 equals $127. We can find the contribution margin per composite unit just like we always do, by taking the sales and subtracting the variable costs. So the contribution margin per composite unit is equal to 235 minus 127, which is equal to $108. Any formulas that you might use in the single unit case now apply to a composite unit. Let's calculate the break-even point in units, assuming that fixed costs are $27,000. You may remember that the break-even point in units is equal to the fixed cost divided by the contribution margin per unit. In our example, that's $27,000 divided by $108 per unit, which equals 250 units. But remember, since we are doing the analysis on the composite unit scale, these are 250 composite units. So the natural question becomes, how many units of each of our three hats would be sold at the break-even point? Well, we know that one composite unit includes 10 baseball caps, 5 top hats, and 3 sombreros. So all we have to do is multiply 250 composite units by each of those quantities. For baseball caps, that's 250 composite units multiplied by 10 caps per composite unit, which is equal to 2,500 baseball caps sold at the break-even point. For top hats, 250 composite units times 5 hats per composite unit equals 1,250 top hats sold at break-even. For sombreros, 250 composite units times 3 sombreros per composite unit equals 750 sombreros sold at the break-even point. Here we have a contribution margin income statement at the break-even point. For the sales, we have the 250 composite units multiplied by the $235 selling price that we calculated at the beginning of the video. That gives us $58,750 of sales. The variable costs are 250 composite units multiplied by the $127 variable cost that we calculated per unit. That comes to $31,750. When we subtract those two numbers, we get the contribution margin, which comes out to be $27,000. You can also calculate that by taking the 250 composite units and multiplying by the $108 contribution margin per unit. And then we can subtract the fixed costs, which are $27,000. So $27,000 minus $27,000 gives us our break-even income of $0. All right, that wraps up our discussion on composite units.